Hey there, Bloomers and friends. Rev Kev coming to you from the Bloom office in Palm Springs, where we are hitting record temperatures this week. More days over 100 than not in this week that we have. So just reminds us where we're living, in a desert where it's hot in the summertime. Not yet summer, but it is almost May. Seems like it's earlier and earlier, or maybe I'm just older and older. I don't know. I know the latter part is true. I'm happy to be with you. We're in our sixth week now of not exactly lockdown, but in Riverside County, strong restrictions. Clearly, it's chafing for some folks who are not wanting to be wearing their masks all the time. This is mine for when I'm in the stores and among people in a closer distance than we are right here. It is also interesting to note, for the first time in my life, I have a concept of the actual 40 days and 40 nights. Remember that? In the Noah story, it rained for 40 days and 40 nights. And Jesus went into the wilderness for 40 days and 40 nights. And then when that was, and he wrestled with, the one without good, sometimes called Satan, sometimes called the devil, and was tempted and that sort of thing, as many spiritual heroes were in their stories. But then the angels came and ministered to him afterwards. So we're waiting for those ministering angels, although we do see them by the good works and the loving and caring that people are doing for one another as we're in this time of restrictions and physical distancing and limitations. It seems like it's going to be probably through the end of May that we continue to have virtual worship, and then we don't know. I mean, we're pretty certain about that. And then we don't know how it'll work, because it doesn't. When will they lift restrictions for gatherings of people larger than 10 or 20? When we have a situation where in the summers we in the past have been having 60 to 70, and who knows what that's going to be in the time to come? We can provide greater distance between the chairs and that sort of thing in the worship area there at the DeMuth Center, but there's going to be restrictions, and we got to see what that means. So here's a thing that I've been thinking about as, co-founder of this congregation. When Mike and I started, there was nothing in the beginning, and it was the gathering first of four of us with the Brown Rigs and Mike and me on that one night, and then the next week there were 10 people at the Bible study, and then it fluctuated. When we went in the March, March 9th of 2003 to have Sunday worship, we had, I think it was 19 people on the first Sunday, and the next Sunday we had six, and then, it was a building. I remember when we went over 20. I remember when we went over 30. I remember when we went over 30 in the DeMuth Center. It's a growth. It's an ebb and flow. I just don't know. So in effect, as a congregation, but the thing is that we are constantly Bloom in the Desert Ministries from the beginning. We're constantly this organization. Now, as a formed and founded and gathered church, we are a congregation. And right now, as a congregation, we are scattered. Remember how I'd say that in the, just think of that first Sunday when we're back together again. We're scattered, now we're gathered. We gather online, we gather virtually, but we're scattered. And it can be a little scary at times to think about, are we losing touch? What we hope is that we aren't. And so we want to, again, encourage people to join us for worship on Sunday morning via Facebook Live, or then afterwards, at least, and connect with us through the YouTube service when it is posted in the early afternoon. Also, hospitality time after worship is a Zoom meeting, and that link is in our Bloom Notes, and you can use that. You can join us for Bible Bites like tonight, and that information is in Bloom Notes as well. You can join one another through phone calls, caring for each other, sending emails, sending notes and cards. All of these kind of ways are ways that we can stay in touch that are not centered only on Sunday morning. The Bloomers Want a Hug Facebook page is very helpful. And here again, I will say, you want to call me, call me. You want to call somebody else, call somebody else. If you are a member or you are in the directory and you need an updated directory to be able to do that, call Bill Wallace, our administrative assistant in the office, and we'll mail a directory to you, an updated directory. Let's just remember that the directories are limited by design to people who are willing to be in the directory, as well as Bloom members and associate members. And that's a way for us to maintain the honor of having the privilege of having people's contact information like that. If you want to get in touch with somebody and you don't know how, I'm happy to contact somebody and say so-and-so is looking to talk to you. All of these ways are ways that we can stay connected with one another, and that's the way in which our ministry remains vital. We also are continuing to serve meals on Mondays. What is it, Russ?
Mondays and Tuesdays.
Mondays and Tuesdays, and that information is available in Bloom Notes, and so follow up on these kinds of things, and that's ways in which we can continue to do that kind of ministry as well as we minister to one another. Let's just also remember as I close up here that we do have masks here at the office that have been created by Ray Lanoue and Fred Kilgus, and we're very thankful for that ministry that they have been doing in this time, not only for us, but for many. Not only for us at Bloom, but for many others as well. In that sense, if you have some friends or somebody who would want one, we're happy to provide those. Perhaps someone would like to make a donation to Bloom of $10 or something like that in order to show appreciation. That's what Ray and Fred have asked, not for Bloom members, but if we're giving them away to others, that maybe there could be some sort of financial support for Bloom that comes as a result of that. So, I hope to see you online. Hope to see you at Bible Bites. Hope to see you at Zoom Hospitality on Sunday. Feel free to, I hope to see you online at Facebook. Let's just stay connected to one another. We love you. We keep you in our prayers. So please keep us in our prayers. See you next time.
Bless the beast and the children, for in this world